Hello viewers, welcome to the Foodie Lounge show presented by IndiaInTracks.com and Suleika.com. Today I'm going to show you how to make a brinjal curry. It's called Kathrikai Kolambu. It's a very different kind of kolambu I'm going to show you, and it has a few steps, about three steps that I will go through with you. Here are the ingredients. I have about half kg of brinjals that have been cut up into quarts. You can see the size of this piece. 1 to 2 tomatoes chopped, curry leaves, toor dal that has to be pressure cooked, tamarind, this is sambar powder, mustard seeds, asafoetida powder, coriander seeds, red chilies, green chilies. I have some turmeric here, fresh grated coconut, salt, and I have some shallots, or otherwise called as sambar onions. So first what I'm going to do is pressure cook the dal. So that's step one. First you need to pressure cook the dal and keep it aside. The second step will be roasting these ingredients to make a fine paste. Just add a teaspoon of oil. To this you would add about 1.5 tablespoons of coriander seeds, 2 red chilies, and about 1/2 teaspoon of asafoetida powder. You can see the coriander seeds have roasted lightly. Now I'm going to add about 4 tablespoons of coconut to this and roast it slightly. So I've roasted it lightly, not too dark. So once the coconut's about light brown color, you can turn it off, cool it and grind it to a paste. Add some water while grinding and make a fine paste. So while we keep that aside, we'll get started with cooking the vegetable. First we need to temper the ingredients, which I have here. Add about 2 tablespoons of oil. To this I will just add some mustard seeds. You can see the mustard seeds crackling now. Add the green chilies, the shallots, add some curry leaves. You can add the vegetables, the brinjals. You can also temper the ingredients in some ghee. It'll taste very good. So I'm going to also add tomatoes. To this I'm going to add some turmeric powder, 1/2 teaspoon, some salt, about a teaspoon of sambar powder. So to this I would add the tamarind puree next. And finally some jaggery to give a little sweetness to this dish. So mix everything well. Leave it closed till the vegetable is completely cooked. Vegetable cook faster, you can add just a little bit of water, about 1/4 cup, and leave it closed for a few minutes till the vegetable gets completely cooked. Paste of the ingredients that I roasted earlier, and I'm going to add this now. The vegetable's cooked and I have the dal which is also cooked. I'm going to add this. You can add a little water at this point to get the right consistency. This is the consistency that you would need. Season with a bit of salt. You can garnish it with a little bit of ghee to give that rich taste. You can also add some chopped coriander leaves. This particular dish is actually a mixture of kolambu and sambar. So because it has the dal in it, it's a very tasty dish and it's a very unique flavor to it. Kathrikai kolambu is ready now to be served. You can have it with steamed rice. It goes best with steamed rice. You can have some appalam or some wafers like vattal or some chips along with this. You can have it with any other dry puriyal.